it's Pusoko here. So a certain two people want to know the process of how I make emotes, so here it is.
Oh my gosh, my tablet is not even plugged in. Okay.
Hey, where does it go? Oh, there it is. Here it is. My tablet's working now. Okay, so I got myself a tablet. It has no screen. It's just a bamboo CTL471. So I start off. Oh, wait. Okay, so Krita. You can go to settings, themes, and then choose a theme you like. People usually like dark themes, right? So I go for Krita Dark. Okay, then I just open a new file. Emotes, you want to make it 112 by 112 because that's the size. Because when you submit emotes to Twitch, there are three sizes. You have to submit in 28 by 28, 56 by 56, and 112 by 112. So I just save it as a preset like this. This is the name of the file, by the way. File name, and then this is, I'm saving a preset right now. So next time I open the program, I can just choose emotes and all my settings, the pixel settings and stuff will be saved. So you create a new document like that. Krita creates two layers for you, one transparent layer, one background layer. I just keep it like that. And then I use the second layer as a sketch layer. Ooh. What emote should I make? Let me think. Usually when I look for references on emotes, I just like write the expression and then animate after so that you can see your face. Okay, let's see what I like. I'll just sketch out different things. So I use the first layer to sketch. I don't like using straight black. I don't know. I forgot why. Is it like an art thing or something? Don't use straight black and don't use straight white. Just use like, not straight black or straight white. Anyway, I like making my cursor or like brush around like 5 pixels. Oh yeah, and then so you can see all the brush presets by going to the side over here and clicking on brush presets. So I used to use a brush like this, right? But then I saw Catherine use I think Catherine and also Pierce uses brushes like this where with more pressure your thing is thicker, then your brush is thicker than if you put like less pressure, right? Like that. Wait, that's not bad. That's a bad example. Like this. Like wait, like this. You know, it has a little tail at the end because you're putting less pressure on. Yeah, like that. That's better. I'll just delete this layer and then make a new one. Oh yeah, so trash can is delete a layer. This adds a layer. To make things more consistent between like emotes of like a set. I usually have one of my older emotes up, like here. Let me find. Yeah, let's just open Puso Derp. Everything is born from Puso Derp. Okay, so what do I do? Oh yeah, so I try to make everything consistent, so same head shape and size and stuff. But we're making a sweat emote. Okay, so I start with a sketch of the general hair. And then, okay, I don't think it's really that consistent, but whatever. Let's just go with it. And then I like zooming out to check if it looks okay as an emote. Sure. I think things look better when you color them. Okay, so now that we have our sketch done, I make line art first, so I like thicken thick TCs. I thicken what I like, the lines I like. Oh, you can make this opacity low by clicking on this layer, your sketch layer. Here, let's name these layers. Sometimes I name layers, I don't know. Sketch, and then opacity lower, so that you can like just trace what you did before, but only the lines you like, right? How do water? How do I make water? I don't know. Nope. Okay, sure. And then I just color things in across emotes. I just like stealing the color. So we have the same color palette. Oh yeah, so you can press control. I hold control, you get the color picker. So you can copy the color from any spot, right? So that's easy. I like this keyboard shortcut, the control for the color picker. It's different on different software, but that's default for Krita, I think. Okay, so what is it copying? I was copying the skin color. Then on an under, a layer below, all the... Oh, you can hide this sketch, by the way. Sketch layer. So on the layer below, all the line art, I start coloring. Anyway, I don't like this face. Let me uncolor some more. Okay, so there's my face. And if I don't like that face, then I can just make another one, right? On top of that layer, I guess. I should be copying this color, the outline color, actually. Oh, whoa. Oh, let me copy the mouth color. There you go. It's better. What? Is that good though? Oh, yeah, and then I have cheek color too. I need to remember my cheek color. The cheek. Oh, let me put it in a different layer. Oh my gosh, I'm getting messy with the layers. Oh well. Got to. This is what I do, at least. You can do whatever you like. Is that good? What? That's how small it's gonna be, I think. Maybe make the eyebrows thicker. The mouth a little bit bigger because you can't really see it from afar. Maybe I should make a little tongue so that it doesn't look like it's just there. Yeah. Something like that. Oh, let me outline the water drop, the sweat drop, so that it doesn't blend in too much with the hair. Just a tiny bit. Maybe a tiny bit more. The sweat drops on this layer, actually. By the way, I messed up. It doesn't even look like water. I don't know. I'm trying. This is hard. Drawing is hard. How do people do this? Oh! Is that even water? Come on. Well, you get the gist of it. That's basically how I make it emo. I think I'm gonna give up on this now. Oh, I do that a lot. I like give up on things. And then I start them on again later when I feel like I have, like I sleep on it and then I look at it in the morning and see what I like and I don't like about it before I actually like finalize it as an emote. Kind of. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, like that. Oh, Topo sweat. That's how you do it. I just do large file size because I don't want it compressed or anything. And, oh shoot. Speaking of transparent, I forgot to hide my layer one. Okay, hide layer one. So then the background's transparent. Save this image, replace it, okay. Then I like previewing. Okay, well I go onto like BTTV or FFC to check out how it looks like and like with the chat preview thing and then the different sizes. Yeah, that's about it. There you go. That's how I make an emote. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Thank you, Janet and Susan, for asking me how I draw emotes and how Credo works. Yeah. Fun fact, I actually heard about Credo for the first time from Vicky because I think one time she was asked, she was looking for like a new drawing program or something, so someone in chat suggested Krita, and then Vicky was like, oh yeah, I've heard of that drawing program, like it's free, right? And that's how I found out about Krita for the first time. Yeah, the end. Okay, bye! Thanks for watching, bye!